Hello friends and welcome to this video. We are going to address the 12th topic from the chapter Linear Prediction and Optimum Linear Filters. So in the previous video we have addressed the AR lattice structure concerned to this designing of the linear prediction and optimum linear filters. Here we continue in this particular direction to see the ARMA processes and further the lattice ladder filters. So let us begin to see what are the exact details of this particular topic to learn advanced digital signal processing. So let us start with. So here we can start with our topic, the topic titled ARMA processes and lattice ladder filters. So as the title suggests, we are going to have the study in two parts. First of all, what are the ARMA processes and then the lattice ladder filters. Already we are covered with introduction to the ARMA processes. AR standing for the autoregressive, MA standing for the moving average. ARMA process, it means ARMA random process, is a special type of the random process. Already we are introduced in our third chapter that it was discrete time random processes. Few of the last topics we had dedicated to introduce these type of the special random processes here. So as we know that the all pole lattice provide the basic building block for the lattice type structure that implement the infinite impulse response systems that contain both the poles and zero. So this we have seen in the previous topic here. And in order to have construction of the appropriate structure, let us have the consideration of the infinite impulse response system having the system function denoted by the mathematical expression where we denote it capital H of Z. It is equal to the ratio, in the numerator we have summation k is equal to 0 to small q carried on to C suffix q of k multiplied to Z to the power minus k, whereas in the denominator we have 1 added to the summation operation for k is equal to 1 to q, 1 to p it should be, or a suffix p of k multiplied by z to the power minus k. So simply we can denote the numerator of this ratio by c suffix q of z, whereas the denominator will be a suffix p of z. So without the loss of generality, let us have the assumption that P will be greater than or equal to Q. So therefore, the system that will be described by the difference equation, here we have the difference equations. First equation is V of N that will be equal to minus of the summation K is equal to 1 to P or A suffix P of K multiplied to V of N minus K added by the discrete time random process X of N. Whereas the second equation is Y of N that is equal to the summation K is equal to 0 to Q carried on to C suffix Q of K multiplied to V of N minus K. So this is what the system represented by these two particular difference equations. So this is basically obtained by just visualizing or considering the system to be a cascade of all pole system that is followed by all zero system. Now from this current equation, the set of two equations, we observe that the output that generally we denote by Y of N, we have at the last equation, it is simply a linear combination of the delayed outputs obtained from the all pole system. So this important point we are going to utilize for the construction of pole zero system here. So as we have the clear identification that G suffix M of N, the prediction error in all pole lattice can be expressed as a linear combination of the present and the past outputs here. So the system here, it will be denoted for the backward prediction capital H suffix B of Z that is equivalent to the ratio of capital G suffix M of Z divided by capital Y of Z. This is equal to capital B suffix M of Z and all zero system. So therefore, the linear combination of the error represented for the filter by G suffix M of N is also an all zero filter. So now let us start with all pole lattice filter. The coefficients will be the reflection coefficients capital K suffix M. For M will be greater than or equal to 1 and less than or equal to small p. And let us add a ladder part by taking this as the output, a weighted linear combination of the error representation by G suffix M of N here. So of course the result will be a pole zero filter that has the lattice ladder structure here. The corresponding output of this lattice ladder structure can be shown by the equation y of n is equal to the summation k is equal to 0 to small q carried on to the multiplication of beta suffix k with g suffix k of n. So here beta suffix k is representing the parameters that determine the zeros of the system here, and the system function we have represented this particular current equation y of n is equal to the summation k is equal to 0 to q d suffix k multiplied by g suffix k of n here. So here it will be of the form for the filter function. We have h of z is equal to y of z divided by x of z, that is equal to the summation k is equal to 0 to q carried on to the multiplication of b suffix k to that of the ratio g suffix k of z divided by x suffix z here. Now here we go to visualize the lattice ladder structure for the all pole zero system here. So here it is, the pole zero system. On the left hand side you see the input represented by x of n is equal to f suffix p of n. At the bottom here we are obtaining g suffix p of n, and on the right hand extreme after the summation we are obtaining the corresponding output here. Now here we have the visualization of the corresponding mth stage of the lattice ladder structure. So here we have at the start f suffix m of n here as input, and on the another end we have f suffix m minus 1 of n here. At the bottom here we have g suffix m minus 1 of n, and on the left hand side bottom we have g suffix m of n, and the corresponding structure here it is shown with the help of the coefficients denoted minus capital K suffix m and the complex conjugate of K suffix m here. Since we know the relationship that x of z is equal to capital F suffix p of z and f0 of z is equal to capital G suffix 0 of z, the earlier equation we can express to the form h of z is equal to the summation k is equal to 0 to q for beta suffix k multiplied to the ratio of g suffix k of z divided by g suffix 0 of z, which is further multiplied to the ratio capital F suffix 0 of z divided by capital F suffix p of z here. So this is equal to 1 upon the system function. In earlier case the representation it was capital A suffix p of z. This is multiplied to the summation k is equal to 0 to q for beta suffix k multiplied to the representation of the system function in the earlier case b suffix k of z here. So finally we can denote capital C suffix q of z equal to, we have the summation operation k is equal to 0 to q for beta suffix k multiplied to capital B suffix k of z. So this was the required relationship that we can utilize for determination of the weighting coefficients that we have denoted by capital, not the capital, beta suffix k simply. So now provided the polynomials capital C suffix q of z and capital A suffix p of z, for the condition that small p is greater than or equal to small q here, we can have the determination of the reflection coefficients generally denoted by capital K suffix I here. So this will be obtained from the filter coefficients A suffix P of K. Further, by the means of step down recursive relation, we also obtained the polynomial represented by capital B suffix K of Z for the values of small k is equal to 1 to 3 and so on up to the maximum small p here. So finally, the ladder parameters can be obtained by the use of this current equation, and the ladder parameters here we denote with the help of the expression capital C suffix m of Z, that is equal to the summation k is equal to 0 to small m minus 1, or beta suffix k multiplied to capital B suffix k of Z, further added to beta suffix m multiplied to capital B suffix m of Z here. So this is equal to capital C suffix m minus 1 of Z added by beta suffix m into capital B suffix m of Z here. The equivalent representation can also be given by the expression where we write capital C suffix m minus 1 of Z equal to capital C suffix m of Z minus beta suffix m multiplied by capital B suffix m of Z. The m will hold the values into the descending order. First of all, it will start at p, then p minus 1, p minus 2, and so on up to it reaches the value small 1 here. So this way, going for this recursion relaxation in backward direction, we can have generation of all the lower degree polynomials here. And since we know that small b suffix m of m is equal to 1, the parameters that we have denoted by beta suffix m are determined from this particular equation, where we said beta suffix m is equal to small c suffix m of m, or m is equal to p, then p minus 1, p minus 2, p minus 3, and so on up to 1 and finally equal to 0. Here, the case when is excited by the white noise sequence, this lattice ladder filter structure will generate the ARMA process here. Discrete time random process can be denoted by ARMA in the bracket small p comma small q, and it will have the power density spectrum described by the mathematical expression. Here it is, capital gamma suffix xx of f expressed in terms of the variance sigma suffix w, it is squared here, and it is further multiplied to the ratio where the numerator is mod square of capital C suffix q of f, whereas the denominator is mod square of capital A suffix p of f here. And along with there, it will be the autocorrelation function, and I have already talked about the variance for the input white noise sequence here. So I think this is the enough information for the ARMA process and the lattice ladder filters associated to the linear prediction and optimum linear filters here. So the same chapter we shall continue into the next topic, where we shall start describing the details of Wiener type of the filters and the prediction type associated to that particular filters. The subtopics are also there, the finite impulse response Wiener filter, the infinite impulse response Wiener filter, the condition of the orthogonality along with the non-causality of the Wiener filter we shall also address thereupon, and will also practice few of the selected problems based on to the understanding we have made in this particular chapter. Thank you.